primitive ancestors didn't have television. Duh.
But they had very active imagination.
If you've ever looked up in the night sky far away from city lights, you can see what they saw. A rich, vast, stellar light show.
With this, these people made their own television.
They saw images in the stars and took their stories of heroes, gods, and goddesses and put them in the sky. You've probably heard of this constellation of stars. Gemini the twins. The two stars Castor and Pollux represent each twin's head.
Other cultures looked at these same bright stars and made up completely different stories.
To the Chinese, the Gemini stars are parts of two constellations, the White Tiger of the West and the Vermilion Bird of the South.
But what were the ancients really looking at? What are we really looking at?
The simple answer. Huge balls of fire, much like our sun. And they're so far away, we don't measure their distance in miles, or even millions of miles, but in light years, the amount of time it takes light to reach us.
So what's a light year? Really, really far. It's the distance it takes light to travel in 1 year, which is this many miles. Almost 6 million miles. 5.878625 trillion.
Let's think about the closest star, the sun. It's 93 million miles away. So how many light years is that? Well, it's not light years, but light minutes. The light from it took a little over 8 minutes to get to it.
Compare that distance to the two stars of the Gemini twins, Castor and Pollux. Castor is 52 light years from Earth. Pollux is 34 light years away from Earth.
So, the time it took for the light of those stars to get to us is not minutes, days, but years. And to travel to Pollux, it would take our fastest spacecraft about 150 days to get to our sun. It would take that same spacecraft nearly 1 million years to fly to Pollux. That's one long road trip.
And Castor and Pollux are really, really close to us. There are billions upon billions of stars throughout the universe, and some that appear to be stars are in fact huge collections of hundreds of millions of stars, galaxies.
Our own sun is a star in a galaxy like this one. If we could view our galaxy from way out in space, our sun